Hello，大家好，欢迎嚟到 FM 105.9嘅文化新生活之家国生活。我哋有惯常嘅几位节目台柱，我系嘉禾总干事黄晓莹博士，你可以叫我 Anna。亦都有我哋嘅名嘴会计师阿 Ben 啦，梁万邦啦，跟住咧我哋嘅监制老萧 Alex 萧啦，同埋时事评论员 Michael 井嘅。咁因为今日系咧大年初一嘅关系啦，我哋嚟个拜个靓年先。即系其实我系想伸只手出嚟攞利是嘅，喺度咁细应该我啦啩，系嘛？咁但係因為咁嘅關係啦，我哋同廣大觀眾拜一年先啦。咁由我開始啦，我祝大家五福臨門、一團和氣、身體健康。
咁 啊，我可以用嘅即系神年輝禄、順泰健康。點解咁講咧？就呢個係即係外國人講廣東話嘅拜年。咁啊，神年輝禄、順泰健康，意思就係新年快樂、身體健康。
咁啊，祝大家係財來運轉啦！咁亦都可以係呢個身體健康、龍馬精神，因為健康咧對於未來一年咧係最重要嘅。
我回应阿 Ben 哥所讲，希望牛年大家牛气冲天，瘟鼠嘅除气全部消除，带嚟一个我哋美好生活嘅新牛年。
咁今日較早時間咧，我哋就訪問咗 Mayor Frank Scarpelli Markham 市長，咁我哋不如去一去條片。咁啊，然之後我哋再討論個情況，好冇？咁啊，先去一條片先，咁樣。
Hi everyone, welcome to FM 105.9 Canada Living. I am one of your regular hosts. My name is Dr. Anna Victoria Wong, the Executive Director of Community Family Services Ontario. We have today our special guest, Mayor Frank Scarpetti from Markham, and our usual hosts, Alec and Ben. 咁事嘅薛家平市長之外咧，仲有我哋慣常嘅主持阿 Alex 蕭公子啦，同埋阿 Ben 啦、梁萬邦嘅。Hi, Mr. Mayor, thanks so much for your time to join us.
你好，你好嘛？And if I could just take a second as well to say 恭喜發財，新年快樂，Happy New Year, Happy New Year of the Ox, and I think all of you know that the Ox represents strength. And perseverance, and goodness knows we need a lot of that these days. So very appropriate that it is the year of the ox. And before we get into some of the issues, I just want to say thank you so much to the Chinese community for the incredible way that they have come together over the last year to support our community. And that's been done by donating PPE, by preparing meals for healthcare workers, by supporting those less vulnerable, more vulnerable in our community. It's been very, very heartwarming to see how you've come together to support each other and look out for each other. And it really is wonderful to have been able to witness all of that in some very challenging times. But I thank each and every one of you and all the organizations that have work so hard to support our community. And great to be with the three of you, Alec, Ben, and Anna, and to be part of the Canada Living Show tonight.
Yeah, thank you. 咁啊，市長啱啱做咗個 greeting 咁樣，咁其實啊 Anna 佢亦都有講到咧，就係萬錦市係啱啱咧就攞咗個 award，就係即係個 Good Employee 排名第18嘅，你有冇啲 detail？
係福布斯雜誌啦，就係喺加拿大咧，就係有頭300位嘅employer 啦。咁萬錦市咧係排第18位啦。咁我哋就係固然啊，市長非常之proud of it 啦，即係大家好值得驕傲嘅一件事嚟嘅。咁因為咧你想做一個好嘅僱主咧，又係真係好破兩頭門噶嘛，係咪？好嘅又要讚，壞嘅又要 discipline，係咪？咁仲要係一個市政府，就用納税人嘅資源嘅話咧，就更加難嘅。所以喺市誒政阿市長喺呢一方面咧，就講咗少少啦嚇，咁樣。
係啦，我哋正話即係打石除棍上，亦都講開咗啊，因為萬錦市本身吸納咗好多精英啦， 咁而經濟亦都係需要精英去扶持嘅。咁我哋嘅問題咧，就曾經問過喺呢個訪問入邊咧，第一個問題就問市長對於經濟嘅睇法，敏感市為經濟康復甦嘅做咗啲咩準備啦。咁市長嘅答覆就講咗俾大家聽，喺過去呢一年嚟咧，喺市嘅能夠做到嘅嘢，例如延長地税啊，唔加費用啊，提供一啲一個webinar 俾大家去小型商業嗰個中心，係幫助大家去解決一啲商業營收嘅問題之外咧，我哋另外仲有一個比較係出眾嘅問題咧，問咗佢就係點樣去喺復甦入邊萬金市做嘅乜嘢咧？佢講過叫做 shop here 或者 Alex 係咪佢好因為佢講話佢提議嘅喺呢個喺幫襯本地做生意。
And then we also worked in the coming weeks to do a number of things that would help businesses. We were the first municipality in all of Canada to jump on the Shop Here program. And this, when the federal and provincial government funded this program to take it nationally, we were the first municipality to sign up. And this allows local businesses who've been used to small businesses who've been used to doing business within their home or in their retail or wherever they do business to take it outside the walls of their business and get an online presence. And so you have, you know, the big companies like Shopify and Google. There's quite a list. I won't go through them all. But what was great was they provided advice and services to companies that wanted to sign up. It was free of charge to the businesses. And what I really liked about it is it built on the connection that we have with York University, because actually it was the students from the Schulich School of Business that helped advise businesses of how to have that online presence. I'm also very proud of the fact that our economic development office and our small business office provided seminars and webinars to help businesses figure out what to do in the middle of the pandemic. And they did this with partners, the Ontario Centers of Innovation, you know, some of the businesses, business organizations, and some of the cultural business associations, a couple of the Chinese ones as well. So that was great, that partnership, the fact that we used forums like this to communicate. The other thing as well that the small business office helped was to give grants to businesses as well, up to $5,000 to help them get their online presence. So they worked with local communities. And later in the year, we also partnered with many of the food delivery services to provide a free service. And that was in the later part of the year, particularly during the holiday season when, because of different restrictions, both businesses and particularly restaurants felt the pinch with further stricter restrictions. And so that partnership with the food delivery service was an opportunity to try and drum up some business for them.
咁啊，呢一段就暫時講到呢度。咁其實佢另Ben go ahead。
其實咧，另外咧，我哋都問咗個關於係呢個萬錦成日都不斷咁去炫耀自己係加拿大嘅科技之都啦。咁佢亦都覺得市長喺另外一個關於點樣萬錦經濟方面為加拿大或者安省有啲咩最更大嘅貢獻咧，佢亦都談及咗一啲喺技術方面、新科技方面嘅領域嘅發展嘅。或者Alex， 你將佢講關於技術方面一個點樣做 technology investor 出嚟嘅一啲意思講。
The last aspect I think you talked about was IT and the new economy. Well, I tell you, I don't think there's a better municipality that's better equipped for that. We're the second largest IT hub in the country. The IT sector is still very, very strong. I just had a meeting with AMD, located here in the city of Markham, over 2,000 employees. They had their best year ever. And they're investing, like the Markham facility here, if it's not the number one, it's very close to being the number one facility with AMD in terms of research and development. And not too long ago, we received an award from the World Data Council. And I can tell you, it was wonderful to see Markham compared to many international cities, how we do on a number of fronts, whether it's sustainability. The number of patents that we have per population, we're ranked very, very high among international cities. And so, yeah, I think we're well positioned. One, because we have the IT companies that are here. We have the ecosystem that supports it. Markham's very fortunate to have attracted people from all over the world. We're the most diverse community in all of Canada, and people have come here, are highly educated, highly skilled, the type of people that those companies, the knowledge-based economy, is going to rely on. And then, of course, with the groundbreaking of York University in 2023, which is literally around the corner when you're trying to build a building and open it up and provide programs, it's a very tight schedule. But they'll open their doors here. And really, the primary purpose of York coming here was the realization that they have companies here that they can work with and develop a curriculum to better prepare students as they enter the workforce in this new economy. And then just to wrap up on that, York University has their Y-Space Innovation Center here. Markham supports Venture Lab, which again helps businesses get into the marketplace, grow existing businesses, enhance exporting opportunities. So people should check out Venture Lab. And then I got to give a shout out to Minister Mary Ng and the federal government because of their investment in the hardware initiative that we have in Venture Lab. And there's another exciting announcement coming with that particular facility. Hardware is obviously very critical. When you think of what cars and almost every aspect of our lives are going to have to do seamlessly, like there can't be a blip. You know, when sometimes Zoom calls get, we freeze in a Zoom call, you can't have that. When you're relying on technology to manage transportation systems and infrastructure and everything else. So hardware is critically important to the success of this knowledge-based economy. And
咁就即係講到呢度啦。咁或者我想同我同米文啊Michael啦，Michael你亦都係一個經濟評論人啦。咁你覺得市長講出嚟話喺嗰個
但總經濟復甦的時候，佢有冇咩實質嘅嘢？你覺得你係聽到佢呢十幾分鐘嘅説話啦？你攞唔攞到啲咩實質嘅嘢？定係話你覺得係仲有好多實質嘅嘢係需要填翻上去個説話入邊嘅咧？
其實個訪問入邊咧有一部分咧，而家冇播出嚟。大家回聽翻嘅時候咧，佢講咗其中一點咧，佢好講好驕傲就話咧，佢係差唔多好快嘅其中一個市咧。 即刻俾咗啲certainty，即係俾啲定心丸啲居民同埋企業就話，到2020年底咧，你哋嘅地税咧都可以暫時交住嘅。即係換之咧，普通居民或者經商嘅話咧，免除咗呢個地税負擔。佢好驕傲呢樣嘢就話，疫情期間大家都人心惶惶，好唔定嘅時候咧，我俾咗定心丸嚟。即係換之咧，令到民眾 或者商界咧應付咗健康，應付咗疫情先，有關嘅支出咧，佢盡量減少。其中係講到有啲税用、有啲費用嗰啲咧，佢嚟減免咗嘅。換言之咧，市方面嘅層次咧，喺聯邦或者省比咧，係相對少嘅。佢就佢自己能力減免啲費用，減輕啲居民同埋啲企業負擔，從而令到可以全心全意去 應付咗疫情，應付咗家庭同埋企業嘅健康先。所以我覺得市長呢點咧係好好嘅。另一方面咧，佢都好驕傲地再重申萬錦市係成加拿大一個好重要嘅科技之都。佢好聰明地，如果同多倫多金融係咁發達嘅時候，佢冇辦法同人比嘅，佢一定要揾一啲 niche。咁而家係二三十年前已經發現到咧，佢 niche 搞科技。
我記得我二三十年前嚟嘅時候咧，我覺得好驕傲地一個好大嘅 IBM 嘅 office， 原來就喺萬錦市。忽然之間喺二三年前十年前 ，IBM 已經睇中萬錦市嘅時候咧，佢朝住呢個方向咧一路咁建立上去。所以就算疫情期間咧，佢都仍然標榜住我哋要重視科研，要將我哋嘅高科技再進一步推高。忽然之間，疫情過咗之後咧。呢個係我哋一個強而有力嘅優勢，從而建立到一個新嘅經濟發展方向。而呢新嘅發展方向亦都配合到阿 Ben 哥問過係話點樣配合我哋綠色能源？綠色能源入邊咧係要好多科技同埋科研去配合嘅。如果你呢個基礎做得好嘅話咧，換之後綠色經濟亦都可以配合住聯邦政府嘅政策一路 build up 上去。呢個係我自己覺得始終喺呢方面有見地同埋有睇法。
咁其實一 positioning 係好緊要啦，係咪？我哋好清楚自己嘅 strength， 同埋呢啲唔係話咧，我有個 policy， 一 tap 手指兩三年就出現咗。其實用咗好多時間嚟 build up， 係咪？中間我哋曾經以為 Amazon 會過嚟添，但係結果都係冇啦，係咪？帶嚟嘅税收啊，同埋租屋啊、房價、交通啊，所有都有影響啦。咁我哋之後亦都有提及到啦。但係身為一個萬錦市嘅居民啦，我都有同阿市長講，我喺屋企行過去個 parking lot， 你就見到你㗎，喺個 officer 喺呢樣嘢嚟講，我覺得我係有一個喺一個身為一個可以話就嚟可以躋身國際大城市嘅地方咧，呢一個係一個緊要同埋 sustainable 同埋好有將來好有 capacity 嘅一個 niche 喎。
但係呢啲咁嘅發展咧，就帶嚟咗一啲問題，可能係喺下一個問題你問嘅時候咧出現咗啦，就係高科技嘅公司通常都吸引一啲有能力嘅人。他們的收入都是比平均的人的收入高的，他們要求的居住環境自然會更加好的，那萬錦市好像又很適合到他們。那我們下一個問題，Anna 你去問市長的時候，就是關於房屋的，是不是？
係啦，咁之後個問題咧，其實有少少就係因為我自己本身係醫療社福界啦，咁亦都係比較關注咧，就係income gap 係咪即係貧富懸殊嘅問題啦？咁萬錦市咧固然係一個有好多有經濟能力嘅人嘅地嘅住所啦，但係咧 York Region 其實包括萬錦市咧，亦都有一個 hidden homelessness 嘅，即係 couch surfing 啊，同埋有啲需要 shelters 啊 temporary housing 嘅地方。咁啊，市長自己亦都話嘅嚇，佢做咗咁多年市長嚟講咧，而家 housing 呢個問題咧已經由代替咗從前嘅交通問題係市區問題嘅第一咧，而家 housing 已經係市區問題嘅第一啦，係另外一個 pandemic 係另外一個疫症嚟嘅。咁佢要重點咁樣去解決呢一個這個問題，咁佢係其實話中意，其實有一個會，佢係唔同個區啦、唔同嘅地方咧，係一齊去做一個 summit 嘅，但係因為疫情嘅關係咧，就一諗褪遲。咁其實我又唔明點解要褪遲咧？開會加下市，你真係要落，
即係開咗啦，而家
係咯，做乜鬼嘢啊？真係係咪咁？係阿 Alex 係咪有片啊？
好，等我去條片先啊。咁呢條片咧就係講呢個收成嘅。
Well, fair to say, and I want to put this in perspective. You know, I think from the first time I ran in my first election, I used to safely say that transportation was the number one issue in the city of Markham, as it is in many communities across the GTA. I haven't necessarily polled anybody, but notionally I can tell you that I think the housing crisis has become the number one issue. And perhaps to your point, you know, it's perhaps something that we know is there. And I guess when you're stuck in traffic, you appreciate the daily frustration of the way transportation has not move forward in the way it should have over the past number of decades because of the lack of investment from senior levels of government, which thank goodness is changing. So you feel that impact every day. I'll tell you, the housing crisis is real. It's quite, so you have people who obviously are more vulnerable because of household income and because of the circumstances that they face, their inability to find subsidized housing because there isn't enough space. We have an incredible waiting list in York Region, one of the highest, if not the highest, in the province of Ontario when it comes to the need for subsidized housing. But now you know, because the, for example, in Markham, the price of a home has more than doubled in the last 10 years. And there, you can see that real estate values and the cost of housing, it has far outpaced incomes. And this is true for professional people. So, when you'd graduate, you'd get your first job, you'd save money, and literally within a few years, you'd probably try to buy your first house and begin, that journey of home ownership. That certainly became difficult over the last decade. And I remember people saying, well, I don't think people will be able to buy a home like they used to. They're going to have to probably settle for a townhouse as their first home. And it wasn't that long ago that people were saying, it's not going to be that far away before a condominium will be someone's first home, because that's all they're going to be able to afford. Well, I'll tell you, this is how tough the crisis is right now. Even a one-bedroom condominium is tough for many professionals to down payment and to make those payments because of the cost of housing. So I want to really stress this is something that I know we've talked about for a few years, but as I said, I think it's probably replaced the number one issue when it comes to what people are concerned about. As frustrating as traffic might be, not having a place that you can live in and call your own and have access to, particularly when your income is at a level that, home ownership will never be something you can attain, but just access to affordable rental and subsidized housing, it is right up there. So if it's not number one, it sure is neck and neck, I'll tell you that much. So on that front, in the inaugural address that I made at the beginning of this term, and I made it on behalf, a commitment I made on behalf of council, was that we would hold a housing summit and bring together thought leaders to tackle this enormous issue and a crisis. If it wasn't for the pandemic, I could tell you that it would be the number one crisis we'd all be dealing with here in Markham and in many communities, and we are. So we were all set in March to actually hold that housing summit, and then because of the pandemic, had to cancel it, and we were kind of waiting to see when we could reschedule it, and finally made the determination to hold it virtually, which we just did last November. Brought together Avi Friedman, a leader in the housing issues. He was our main speaker. I was glad to see that Federal Minister Ahmed Hussein was there, along with Premier Doug Ford, along with Steve Clark, Minister of Municipal Affairs. I'll tell you, to have those people kick off a housing summit, to me, also indicates how serious the issue is. And then we
咁我哋嚟到呢度停一停，因為佢即係 bring up 咗一個好 important 嘅 point， 就話其實咧就係 affordable housing 呢樣嘢咧，就唔係淨係 market 嘅問題，其實 actually 係 Ontario 嘅問題啊。咁喺呢個問題，咁大家有啲咩意見啊？不如揾阿 Michael 講先好嘛？
我覺得就話咧，一個城市醫院點樣取得平衡咧，一啲都唔容易。好似你所講，呢、這個問題唔係淨係 market 出現。多倫多阿 John Collier 都成日講嘅，就話點樣可以建立多啲可負擔嘅房屋咧？咁呢方面咧，一直都係落後於計劃嘅。所以我哋 Markham 亦都唔係唯一嘅城市出現咗問題。但係正如頭先 Ben 哥同埋其他人講，就話如果你將我哋個城市 positioning， 好似 Anna 話齋，我哋好重要做 positioning。如果 positioning 一個 high tech capital 嘅話咧，一定會引嚟高地價。你睇你嘅直谷咧，嗰、那個地價都唔平嘅，嗰、那個、屋價都唔平嘅。如果你真係要強化呢樣嘅時候咧，我哋有個 trade off， 有即係有權衡啦，就話要得呢樣又唔要得嗰樣。所以呢樣嘢咧，始終係一個好頭痛嘅問題，點樣解決？又要照顧到負擔唔到一份，亦都吸引啲高人才嚟， 又要啲發展商起啲好嘅樓俾啲有人有能力有經濟能力嘅人嘅話咧，點樣兩者之間取平衡咧？就真係睇下點樣難嘅。
阿 Ben 咧 ，Ben 有咩意見啊？
嗱，其實咧，我對於房屋嘅睇法咧，就覺得我哋加拿大人實在太奢侈。如果我哋要喺一個好奢侈嘅問題上去研究點樣唔好咁奢侈，我哋唔係一個腳踏實地嘅問題上去研究點樣腳踏實地，因為我哋係嚟自原居地係一啲好人煙密集嘅國家，新加坡、香港、澳門、中國大陸，其實整個亞洲地方日本都是很密集的，但他們為什麼都可以生活得那麼自在，沒有覺得房屋是一個這麼大的問題，因為政府放了很多資源去做政府屋，第一，第二，全部都是以交通引導 居民，相反地加拿大一定要有居民去引導交通，這些這樣的思維可不可以改變呢？第一，第二個就是說我們在發展房屋方面是不是還要每人要150呎或者350呎才叫做最低要求呢？我看這個世界平均，我們每一個國家我們居住的環境是什麼東西呢？如果我們是要跟世界扯平來看，我們就需要可能屈就一下加拿大人，我們就有 affordable housing 可負擔房屋，但我們要繼續在奢侈上面談少許奢侈呢，我們是很奢侈，我經常覺得是一個很奢侈的問題，所以我覺得要大家腳踏實地呢，就會將房屋問題解決咗噶啦。點解我哋間屋一定要一人一個廁所嘅咧？點解我哋間屋要一人一間房唔得噶？三個人住六間房啦，起碼一個書房啦，一個第日外父外母嚟俾間房去住啦。哇，預預到咁充足嘅，呢啲係咪好奢侈咧？咁我希望大家咧係可以咧實際地喺房屋居住方面出發，再從交通能夠配搭到咧，幾遠都有人去住噶。
喺我哋講交通之前我想回應少少阿 Ben 同埋市長啦。我覺得佢冇講過一樣嘢，而我係有喺個問題度問過嘅，就係 shelter affordable housing 係咪？佢就係即係咧，好似我啲 counselor 咁，係咁 validate 我哋個 feeling， 係咁話俾我哋聽啊！我真係覺得呢個好大問題，係咁你個 solution 係咩咧？我臨尾終於聽到，哦，原來佢有個 summit 要一齊傾，咁但係其實而家先 summit 先傾，我覺得咧，如果我瞓街瞓咗好耐街啦嚇，咁即係但係我哋要成一個 green belt 之都，我哋想個 IT capital 並唔代表我哋冇窮人。即係喺 IT capital 裏邊一樣係有有 mental health issues 嘅人啦，一樣係有要離開暴力屋企嘅人啦。咁其實有啲中轉房屋 temporary housing 同 shelter 係好需要嘅。市長有提過 modular housing， 佢主要係講貧窮線以下嘅人嘅 housing， 但係就忘記咗我哋頭先講嗰類即係走佬救命嗰種 housing 咯。
好，不如我哋轉頭即係下半場繼續呢個問題，好冇？停一停，轉頭翻嚟。
Hello， 大家好，歡迎再翻嚟我哋 FM 105.9嘅文化新生活之家國生活。我哋咧今晚有四位台主主持啦，嚇監製蕭公子啦，時事評論員 Michael 井啦，梁萬邦我哋嘅會計師啦，同埋我哋社福界嘅代表係 Anna 嘅。咁我哋頭先咧就講起我哋今日朝頭早咧就其實我唔知幾時啦嚇，訪問咗阿萬金市市長薛家平 Frank Scarpitti。咁我哋咧阿蕭公子咧其實有幾個錄影片段咧就喺我哋一路而家做評論嗰時播啦。咁我上半場就講了疫情後經濟復甦的 plan， 同埋講咗有關萬金房屋啦，同埋 IT 之都 IT Capital of Canada 呢啲咁樣嘅發展方針嘅。咁但係因為講到房屋嘅關係咧，亦都我哋 anticipate 之後嘅移民會越嚟越多啦，係咪？咁即係又要多啲人嚟先至可以做到生意容易，係 critical mass 噶嘛，係咪？但係嚟到之後咧，我哋可能有冇屋住啊，要推高房價，唔夠水唔夠電啊，交通擠塞啊咁樣。咁我哋其實咧就住呢方面都有問過市長問題過，係咪 Alex？
係，其實咧 before 即係講下一個即係 housing 嗰樣嘢，我想就回應翻上半場我未講嗰啲嘢。咁其實市長講緊個 housing summit 咧，就係即係當然舊年11月做過啦。咁其實今年咧啱啱上個禮拜咧，佢已經出咗個 affordable 嘅 housing 嘅 strategy 出嚟㗎啦。咁其實有好多方案嘅咁樣。咁譬如佢簡單講咧，就話萬金咧就希望咧就即係佢喺嗰啲 development 佢所謂嘅 development 嘅 centre 嗰度咧，佢咧就會 target 有部分嗰啲即係喺 high density 嘅 neighborhood 咧，就佢會咧就話喺 condominium， 譬如 10% 咧就係、是、需要咧就係、是、呢個 affordable 嘅 unit， 咁然之後咧5% 咧就 affordable rental， 所以 affordable 嘅 unit 就即係話即係有啲 first time buyer 可能啲錢唔夠啊，咁所以咧就即係希望有啲比較平啲嘅，咁通常佢以細啲嘅單位嘅，咁譬如話好似呢個係佢分開幾個 percentile 嘅，咁其實咧就即係。去到30,000+ exactly 個 range 唔係好記得啦。咁佢有個 category 咧，就低啲收入嘅就 target 去俾個 bachelor suite 嘅，再高少少嘅就一個房嘅，跟住再兩個房，一個三個房咁樣分開曬啲 income bracket 嘅。咁但係因為嗰啲價錢咧就係2018年嘅，其實兩年之後已經起咗一輪啦，係咪？咁所以其實、那個即係令到咧，譬如話佢我睇到嗰啲價錢，如果係 bachelor suite 咧。因為嘅房屋個屋價起咗，佢加好似800蚊尺咁樣，咁係大約咧就係300尺到嘅 bachelor suite 啊，咁然之後 one bedroom 咧係400尺松啲嘅，可能未到400尺添啊，咁就係基本上如果你唔夠400尺咧，似乎家攞唔到 mortgage， 咁成日其實所以其實個 plan 唔係話咁特別，即係已經 up to date 嘅啦，因為樓價升得咁快。咁所以其實佢哋家都拗曬頭，咁點樣轉咧？係咪要轉做 affordable rental 咧？就有好多其他啲一啲方式。咁所以呢個 plan 咧，其實咧就係 ongoing 繼續做緊嘅。咁所以家下咧，其實 housing 係一個好 high priority 嘅問題啊。咁跟住，
我想回一回啊 Anna 曾經問過個問題：如果有啲真係要瞓街急救嗰啲 affordable housing 都太長遠嘅咯喎。他們已經在明天就被業主趕出街了，他沒辦法在的時候政府不接濟，或者有沒有一些收容的 shelter 收容中心的話，基本上他們是沒有可能即時有地方可以安居，真的要睡街嗎？我們在說這些 affordable housing 和這個問題解決不了，是不是？
其實是幾困難的，因為學你說的，如果是要好像其他城市那樣建一些公屋那樣，那要拖很久。曾經我哋70年代、80年代做咗一輪，大約全加拿大有50萬個 unit 咁樣，但係喺嗰陣時就停咗，而家似乎要 resume 翻嗰樣嘢，咁所以呢樣嘢大家傾緊，咁所以咧就自由黨已經講咗話有550億係做呢樣嘢，但係三級政府要一齊做，咁佢哋起咗個頭，其實咁賴兩年咧，呢個 plan 出咗嚟2年定3年，其實未有好大進展。咁所以可能咧呢樣嘢咧就會繼續重蹈覆轍噶啦。阿 Ben， 你好似想再繼續講 housing
呢？因為啱啱聽到就係話政府辦緊事又好，或者加拿大整個政府都好啦，都係想將我哋居住嗰個要求咧，係可能由400尺變300尺變細少少咯。但係我哋加拿大真係地好多啦，咁我哋嗰個城市規劃發展係好完善嘅，但係喺完善嘅情形之下。為了追求完美，令到很多人瞓街，定係我哋會唔會考慮市政府發展嘅時候咧，將呢個完美嗰個要求係唔好去100分啦，80分嘅時候，咁將嗰個可提供居住嘅條件降低咗之後咧，可居住嘅地方自然發展咧就會多好多啦。
係咪即係咧？唔好淨係愛嚟起豪宅，起啲實用啲嘅。
嗰一樣嘢，如果有個人，如果我要起一間屋出嚟 affordable housing 高咗之後影響到你嘅 back up 睇月光嗰少少景，你出嚟趌一趌，我成個 project 就會胎死腹中噶啦。因為有個人出嚟話：我你間屋高咗，影響咗我睇月光嗰個景。咁我哋因為民情嘅需要咧，這個咁嘅申請又要可能3年6年先搞掂。呢啲咁嘅繁文縟節，滿足個人嘅自由得崇信得咁緊要嘅時候，如果有大問題要解決，我哋可唔可以就話？你不好意思了，我是遮住看月光的了，你曬月光去大家屋曬啦，我哋要俾好多人呢、這個 project 好多人有機會在入邊居住嘅咁。
嗱呢啲嘢咧就阿 Ben 哥先有資格講嘅啫。咁如果你要我講嘅話咧，我就咁咧咁啲翻學啊，即係要有社區配套啦，係咪？即係多咗人嘅話，要多咗中小學啦，多翻啲 daycare 啦，同埋你多咗人，即係多咗commuters 喺翻工嘅話咧，都需要個交通上面配合多啲咯，係嘛？
係啦，我都講咗交通可以主導。房屋發展，但係我哋見唔到人坐車，我哋就唔開展交通。這個就一直加拿大發展交通嘅。
哇！講一條三個站嘅濕位都講咗20多年咯，去咗我半條命啊！
係咪？唔係，咁係咪時候應該講下啲
交通啦？
講下啲 transportation 係嘛？咁其實咧就加下即係近期咧就 work from home， 咁咧就可能呢個係一個paradigm shift 啊。因為很多 corporate 咧，發覺佢哋七成的人咧都可以 work from home 嘅。咁如果呢個係即係加拿大 emphasize 嘅工作係 work life balance 啊，咁所以其實呢個咧就係可能有啲企業咧，因為員工嘅需要，咁亦都係即係或者員工嘅即係嘅福利啦，咁可能咧就會做呢個轉變咁樣。咁我哋不如去一去條片，咁睇下市長咧就點樣答呢條問題。咁啊先答呢條問題，咁跟住有其他啲 transportation 嘅問題㗎。
Well, let's just deal with the work at home aspect of it, and you know the suggestion that somehow we won't need as much transportation in the future as we thought we might. First thing, I think the jury is still out on to what extent post-pandemic people will be working from home. I personally believe yes, there will be some changes. I'm no futurist, but I think that there'll probably be a hybrid system. And I hope that that actually does relieve some of the pressure that we do face during the peak hours. But the reality of when we get back to normal life is that, you know, there'll be a big percentage of the people that will still go to their place of work. People will either through school buses, public transit, or unfortunately, in some cases, where people drive their kids to school. So that adds to the peak demand, particularly in the morning peak. But I think the jury is still out to what extent there will be the work from home. I've heard people at one end of the spectrum saying, okay, enough of this. I got to get back to my office. I can't do this anymore. To people who say, hey, I could do this a little bit more than I realized I could. And in others who also recognize that they're probably somewhere in between. I don't think we've polled our employees recently, but I know halfway through last year, it wasn't a big majority, but actually a majority of the employees said they do want to return back to work. So I found it kind of interesting. And I'd say that maybe that number may go up slightly after a few more months of having to experience what we just experienced. So I don't think the jury is out. It's hard to really assess, and that's going to be globally. What I like about the fact is that our way of thinking has changed, and the realization that we can use technology to a much greater degree. So will we still need places of work? I think we do. IBM, I can just tell you notionally, many, many years ago, they actually encouraged their employees to work outside the office. And they, I don't know if they had specific targets, but they wanted them outside the office. And then just a few years ago, I remember, and I go to the IBM headquarters, on a regular basis because Venture Lab is there, but also because of activities IBM is holding. A few years ago, they commented, the number of people saying, you know, the old IBM is back. And I said, what do you mean? Well, they went the other way where they wanted employees to spend a certain percentage of their time in the office because they felt they'd lost their identity and a bit of their culture. And now when you see what IBM has done, I tell you that I think that culture is as strong as it ever was. And
咁我哋就聽到呢度啦。咁其實即係 work from home 呢樣嘢咧，大家點睇啊？阿 Anna 講先啦 ，Anna 家有個 office 啊，咁啊成日都做 virtual。
我覺得work from home 環保之餘咧，對於即係家庭有啲負擔嘅人，即係例如定時定候接仔啊嗰啲咧，係嗰個 flexibility 對佢好重要㗎嚇。咁呢一個就係人際啊、家庭啊、關係啊、責任方面啦。但係同時咧，我亦都喺我唔係經濟大師咧，有大把響呢樹啦，四個裏邊有三個啦，係咪？咁但係即係我會覺得，咁其實你咪商務租咪會降低啊，即係多咗地方租。 吉嘅鋪啦，同埋可能商務方面嗰個尺數嗰個租金會唔會降低，係咪一件好事？即係咁而家都唔夠位住咯，不如俾翻多啲地方住啦，唔使咁多鋪頭啦。其實即係難聽啲講句，你自己老土啫，你覺得你 staff 入咗嚟先做嘢，即係佢咧其實要唔做嘢嘅話，佢坐足佢有十個鐘，佢都可以係唔做嘢嘅。
阿 Michael 咧 ，Michael 覺得點啊？
其實你聽阿市長講咧，佢會覺得咧個份安排係一個權宜之計，暫時性嘅。佢成個回答邊咧，佢骨子裏都覺得咧，當回復到正常嘅時候咧，啲人都會翻翻辦事處。換言之咧，期望因為呢個份安嘅短暫現象咧，係緩和咗屋價咧。我個人感覺到佢講得唔實際嘅。同時佢仲講嗰樣嘢咧。我哋而家萬景市入邊嘅交通設施咧，係遠遠落後於需求嘅，即係唔知道要加大嘅供應去滿足個需求，即係話唔知咧呢啲咁嘅嘢咧，都有交通方面配套配合成個城市發展。喺咁嘅情況之下咧，我覺得佢最終都覺得咧，兩三年之後或者長遠啲嚟講咧，我哋嗰個房屋需求仍然好大，我哋交通需求仍然好大，而不同方面 concept 咧。我聽見啦，我聽見佢感覺或者理解就話唔會長遠，換言之咧，我哋唔可以將呢個成為一個永久嘅現象。
阿 Ben 咧，
呢個理解。
啊，我咧就無論喺咩場合，我對於 work from home 都保留得好緊要噶，因為我覺得工作時工作，娛樂時娛樂。你唔喺娛樂時工作，工作時娛樂，你都唔喺廚房瞓覺，亦都唔喺飯廳打麻雀，你去。娛樂廳打麻雀，你做你的事在翻適當的時候、適當嘅地方去做。原因工作不是去 deliver 成果，工作是一個過程。工作很多時候是大家分享，有個團隊的精神，有個大家去可以互相去鼓勵、互相去比較、互相去推崇更高一個層次。不是每個工作都可以是獨當一面地咧，係唔需要同其他人聯絡，然之後做成呢個工作。咁喺不得已，而家疫情之下，我哋先要選擇呢個方法去做呢件事。但係當經濟回復正常嘅時候，我相信大家都有希望機會出翻著翻件靚靚衫，唔好再攞住口罩遮住，連唇膏都唔使搽。即係其實人係一個生活，人係需要面對更多唔同嘅一個質素嘅生活，唔係你喺屋企著件睡衣去 deliver 一樣嘢出嚟，揼個木箱出嚟。每日要揼20個木箱，揼完掟翻俾公司老細就得噶啦。其實揼個木箱嘅時候，如果有其他人喺你身邊同你回響、互相分享點樣揼呢個木箱，那個木箱做出嚟個價值可能更高、更有效益嘅。呢個係我個睇法咧，就係話認為不放空唔係一個長遠解決工作嘅一個方式方法嚟。
咁我就用另一個角度睇啦，即係大家如果即係我最近咧留意到咧，喺 downtown Toronto 咧有三個大嘅 IT 公司咧，就係即係。增加了他們的 rental 的 space， Amazon 拿了10万只、Google 也是拿了10万只咁上下 ，Shopify 如果我冇記錯是拿80万只嘅，咁所以其實咧就即係呢啲科技公司咧，其實即係好似 IBM 咁樣，係其實要喺即係 work in the office 有 team play 有 team spirit 咧，同埋佢哋要 moving things so fast 嘅，咁所以如果即係譬如啲 management 咧。都希望員工在 office 佢好快有啲咩嘢，佢可以即刻喺個 office 嗰度處理，然之後唔使擔心喂誒邊個喺邊度啊，或者即係可能 distract by 個 home activity 啊，咁所以其實相對嚟講，可能大家諗緊嘅就都係會係即係可以回復翻常態，但可能有部分嘅咧就係要求話喂 work life balance 嘅，亦都可能會容許 allow to work from home 嘅，咁所以呢、這個即係我諗係。有一個改變，但應該不是一個很大的改變。
我想不是一個either or 啦，係 complementary 啦，係咪？即係市長都話 most likely a hybrid situation 係咪？即係其實咧學校咧，你多咗 online classes 咧，喺外邊嘅人亦都可以讀啦，咁佢嘅收入又會多咗啦。咁即係僱主嚟講，有啲真係唔需要租咁多咁大地方，唔同嘅工種咧亦都可以負擔少咗啦。hybrid 咯，即係會多咗一個 modality 去做事，而唔係我哋一係就翻工，一係就喺屋企。我諗唔係嘅。
但係你只話你哋都有講及係 work balance life 同 work， 我寧願你翻工不過一個乜而家個星期翻三日啦，放四日假都總好過 一個星期翻五日，有兩日嘅放空。對於一個僱主嚟講，僱主係選擇你一個星期翻三日就算啦。你要life 同 work balance， 你另外四日喺屋企冇所謂，但係唔好話你係翻緊工。我 work hard play hard 唔好 mix it up， 千祈唔好以為翻緊工嘅時候你係享樂緊，亦都唔好以為自己享受緊係翻緊工。你享受就享受，翻工就翻工。
咁咧就
我聽哥所講，市長講嗰樣嘢咧，其實雙軌嘅，即係如果我哋發現到咧，可以翻工嘅時候咧，我哋以後可以唔排除呢個可能性，但係亦都要翻工。好似 Ben 哥話齋，五日入邊有兩三日翻工，有兩三日屋企嘅時候咧，變成雙軌嘅時候，都好似 Anna 所講，以後我哋成日 hybrid 嘅話咧，兩面走啫嘛 ，office 同埋屋企兩面走咯，咁就係。
好，跟住另外 transportation， 我仲有其他啲問題，會話我曾經問佢咧，就話 work from home 令到啲peak loading 少咗。咁如果呢個係 paradigm shift 啊，咁佢 which 未 proven 啦，佢哋喺個 transit 嗰度有冇改變啊？咁所以就我哋去一去條片先啊。
And when you take a look at the growth that's happening in the GTA, again.Certainly predictions and some of it validated by what's happened over the last number of years. There's 100,000 to 150,000 people coming to the GTA in the next 20 years. And so, you know, that's over 2 million people. York Region's going to get a certain percentage of that. And already our population projections have grown because we used to plan.About 20, 30 years out. Now we're planning 40 years out. And that's both a good thing and sometimes a curse, but I think a good thing to realize, hey, when we're planning infrastructure, let's make sure we know, at least to some degree, how many new people, new businesses will be in our community. And so we need to continue with the investments on the GO line.The GO line to Unionville GO station has been planned for 15-minute service, and we need that because when you look at, you mentioned Markham Center, you know, and the plan, as plans do, evolve. The last time we looked at Markham Center, there's 40,000 people will eventually live there. That's between Warden and Kennedy, south of 7, north of 407. So imagine 40,000 people.And another 40,000 people working there over time. So when you have that kind of density, you need rapid transit. We're trying to curb urban sprawl, and urban sprawl has its issues. But when you have density and it's not supported by rapid transit, those problems multiply them by 1,000 times, because then you've got a real problem if you don't have that transportation network. So absolutely, the investments being made on the GO lines has to continue.The extension of Yonge Subway, absolutely critical. I've said this before, and I continue to say it. It's the top priority for York Region, but it's the most justified rapid transit investment. And that is proven out. There's other investments, and I'm not critical of them because I think in the long run they help, but there's other projects that were approved before Yonge Street extension.That didn't have the ridership that Yonge Street has. There's over 1,300 daily bus trips that take place on that corridor. And also with the extension of the what's happening in the area of Yonge and Highway 7, when you take a look at the Langstaff plan, that's just on our side, never mind Richmond Hill. When we approved Langstaff,It was the most densest community in all of the GTA. And why? It was based on the commitment that the Yonge Subway would be extended and that other transit improvements would happen. So those plans can't come about unless those rapid transit investments are made. On the issue of road widenings, again, when we're now going and taking a look, we're doing a municipal comprehensive review for York Region.When we finalize the population targets, not just for the region, but specifically for Markham, of course, we'll always continue to evaluate. And the other thing too, Alec, because you asked the question, technology will also make us look at things differently. So if there's new technology, a way to do self-driving buses for the last mile from the GO station to your home, obviously technology will always make us think about what's the best way to invest, but I can just tell you, we're behind in road transportation capacity. And when I see what's out there today in the midst of a pandemic, and there's some afternoons where I've had to go out and I realize, well, this is in the pandemic and look how busy it is. So when we get back to normal, we're going to be, you know, we forget, but we're going to be reminded pretty damn quickly how far behind we are. So yes, we'll continue to evaluate the road widenings. Take a look, is there, maybe we start at the intersection, use technology to improve traffic flow. All those things will be done. But, you know, at the end of the day, we have to make sure that we're building capacity, because right now we don't have enough capacity. And we know that we're going to continue to grow into the future. And then one last thing.
暫時講到呢度，因為另外有一個問題講407，我哋一陣間有時間先講。大家覺得佢講呢個嗰啲infrastructure expansion，有咩comment咧？
阿 Ben，我住喺 Markham 已經住咗20年啦。我記得我搬上嚟嘅時候咧，我住 Kennedy 同16+200。我20年前搬上嚟咧。Kennedy 都是全部都是農地，是沒有的，但是現在今時今日一路 Kennedy 以東一路掃到去好東好東，現在起曬屋的話，你看看這20年那個房屋興建的數量，人口增長的數量，尤其看看我們道路建設交通運輸的配套的話，好像麥錦市市長都承認是遠遠不足的，所以未來的步伐就是怎樣加快嗰、那個交通配套，點樣將嗰個交通改善？因為交通改善咗，人流改善咗咧，先可以帶動到經濟嘅。所以我覺得市長呢方面咧，係睇中咗問題，一定問題話點樣將呢個問題一步一步解決。
阿 Ben 咧，
其實我覺得要喺解決交通問題咧。我好似同你傾過關於就係話一個15分鐘可以到達嘅所有嘅地方。如果將人類規範喺一個15分鐘可以，無論你生活所需嘅嘢，大致上基本上可以滿足到嘅話咧，無論你用咩交通工具，15分鐘都可以去到嘅話咧，呢一種咁嘅城市設計咧，就會減輕人類對交通、居民對交通嘅依賴，亦即係減輕咗嗰個擠塞度嘅。咁我好希望就係話。正話阿 Michael 講啦 ，Kennedy 以北 ，Kennedy 以東都係農田一片過咗 Major Map 過咗16+街，但係而家起咗咁多路少咗，因為佢起屋出嚟全部都係一層兩層過，住嘅人全部個個要揸車。如果起一等大廈出嚟一條地鐵道，起多200等大廈都賺唔滿條地鐵啊！但係佢哋唔係咁去設計啊嘛，佢係要起啲屋出嚟。佢起咗100間屋出嚟，多咗200架車，條路冇闊到，但係佢冇諗過起一頂大廈多300户出嚟，帶條地鐵過去送曬落單攤，或者用輕軌，完全冇諗過呢啲方法。一味就要講求順暢，我要睇到 back 一曬到月光先叫做屋。咁呢種咁嘅生活習慣就要付出代價，就日日坐個巴士度，坐407度，坐架車度喺度捱下塞車咯。呢個冇得揀㗎啦。
Anna 咧？
我覺得咧，我哋可以 anticipate 到呢幾年咧，因為呢個救生艇嘅 program 關係啦 ，right 會有一扎好有工作能力嘅人過到嚟嘅。咁嗰一扎會係日日要翻工嘅，即係無論佢屋企翻工定係出街翻工，係咪？我亦都因為而家樓價嘅關係啦，同埋佢哋可能走得急嘅關係啦，好承接到阿 Ben 頭先講嗰類 condo 盤咧。是 OK 的，即是如果我是發展商的話，我都可能會不太擔心要開多些這些樣盤，那就即是對於即是同一個平方尺的地呢就可以善用多些啦，那生意在萬錦市會好做一些，因為始終我們講加拿大最難做的生意就是 critical mass 啦，我記得以前 Ben 是不是講過加拿大的好處就是地多人少，個唔好處亦都係地多人少，係咪？生活好，但係生意難做。咁但係如果喺同一個地方裏邊多啲人嘅，你自然會繁榮。你嗰個15分鐘生活圈係容易啲 build 到嘅嚇。咁亦都係因為咁嘅情況之下咧，可以多啲高樓大廈啦，可以配合到喺個 IT capital 咧，其實有高樓大廈一啲都唔出奇咯。係咪？咁就真係可以嚟個一帶一路啦。我哋有人，你俾條 belt 我哋，就係嗰個 highway 又好，或者你條 rail 又好嚇。
你睇到啊喺灣嗰邊咧 ，Warren Metro Centre，Metropolitan Centre 發展嗰度，係我話睇佢起啲 condo 最大嘅樓盤，最短時間賣曬。呢、這個就係 Warren 佢哋有咁嘅能力，因為以往個交通部長安省交通部長喺 Warren 出嚟嘅，所以佢條地鐵拉到嗰度咯，就簡單咯。咁所以
我哋要勁啲嘅老鼠仔去咬翻翻嚟係嘛？
係。咁其實我就想講少少歷史啦，即係其實呢個純粹係 urban planning 嘅問題啦。咁即係以前咧，我哋廿年前，我同 Michael 都一樣，都係搬嚟 Markham 嘅。嗰陣時咧，其實咧，啲屋好大，亦都係好平，三零萬到嘅啫，係嘛？咁有二千至三千尺都有噶啦。咁所以喺嗰個時間咧，我哋係即係把握係個 quality of life， 咁係 dream house 啊 ，grow kid。但係二十年之後咧，其實個情況就好唔同啦，因為多咗移民嚟啦，然之後咧就亦都係大部分喺 GTA 啦。咁令到我哋每年咧就都係有即係個 population growth 個 capacity 唔夠啊，咁所以喺大約十五年前到咧，安省啊整咗個叫 place to grow， 即係意思係佢想控制啲人唔好一直係咁向北發展或者向東發展咁樣，咁所以咧就即係要佢有組織性嘅，咁令到 GTA 同埋馬蹄嗰度咧係有35個交通樞紐。咁啊，譬如 Markham Union Mill 係其中一個 ，Richmond Hill Centre 一個 ，Cornell 係一個 ，Downtown Toronto Union 又係一個。咁啊，將所有嘅 GTA 嘅城市咧就 join together， 用呢個 transit， 咁佢咧就又整 LRT 或者 subway 啊，咁然之後咧就再愛嚟做呢、這個即係個 transit corridor。咁然之後希望喺 transit corridor 嗰度咧就起啲高樓大廈。嗰啲 density 即係好啲嘅，咁希望喺啲 regional centre 嗰度咧，整個所謂嘅15個 minute 或者甚至乎20個 minute 嘅 community 係 self live work and play 咁嘅情況，咁所以咧 ，in a way 咧就想將啲人咧就係擺喺啲 high 嘅 density， 佢可以 build infrastructure， 可以 move 啲人喺個 GTA 嗰度工作又好，乜都好，生活又好嚇。咁令到咧 ，at the same time， 因為佢哋喺呢個交通網絡嗰度住，咁令到相對嚟講咧，就想解決呢個 transportation 嘅問題。但係時至今日，似乎個成效咧就係、是、即係似乎係 one 係做到呢樣嘢，其他啲 city 都係好似係循序漸進咁樣式。咁所以其實
因為嗰條地鐵係永遠都塞唔到過去啊嘛，完全冇咁嘅人有咁嘅。膽，因為今日耕田，明日收穫。我今日耕田俾人鬧，加税；明日地鐵通咗，我已經唔係政府啦，就係呢個政府嘅嚴重結構性問題，係冇一個政府肯犧牲我今日嘅聲譽，然之後咧做一個偉大嘅長遠嘅基建工程出嚟，係兩任三任後政府先至承擔到後果，見到成果嘅。我咁點解我做？做咗之後咪容乜嘢俾人攞落台？呢、這個就係、是。冇長遠見嘅，唔係一個我個人嘅睇法。
啊，即係十五六年前佢有個藍圖嘅，嗰藍圖咧就其實就好即係好廣闊嘅。咁而且咧就即係 at the same time 嘅 plan for 即係二三十年後嘅。咁但係咧當時嘅 MetroLink 係專門負責即係搞啲交通咧個網絡啦，咁做統籌。其中一樣嘢咧，因為納税人嘅問題咧，就佢希望咧就有個即係有 benefit。咁所以每一條即係建設一條每一條路咧，都要有個 business case。咁因為有個 business case， 我哋亦都唔夠呢個 traffic loading， 唔夠呢、這個嗰啲 traffic 個 throughput。咁所以好多嘢咧就遲就未去。咁所以其實我覺得呢個可能係一個技術上邊嘅問題。有陣時你話 infrastructure， when you build room， people will come。即其實大家都知道呢樣嘢，但係我哋就轉咗個方式，因為要對市民負責，對省民負責，咁所以咧就係整咗個 business case， 令到呢啲嘢咧就去唔到啊！
呢個就係美其名對人負責，係要對自己張選票有着落，唔係對佢負責。我張選票有着落，我就會做；冇着落，我做嚟做乜咧？
但係其實佢出個 plan 嗰陣時咧，呢、這個估計到係個問題。咁只不過可能咧就 premier 或者即係Ontario 冇個 political will， 話唔好講咁多，話做就做，唔好理佢啦，啊照做啊，因為反正好似 covid， 大家睇到點使錢法啦，啊咁有時。
但係冇一樣嘢，我突然之間想講， COVID 使咗4000亿啦，联邦政府嗰4000亿冇一条，每一蚊落咗啲正正式式嘅建设上，全部落上人啲袋，然之后攞咗炒股票，跟住就攞咗去炒下楼咁，冇真真正正摆落起多3间医院，或者起多间发电厂，或者起多2条公路，起多条地铁，呢啲钱冚唪见唔到，使落去一啲可以将来会受用嘅地方，因为呢啲受用嘅地方又系攞唔到选票嘅，只会好似今日联邦政府咁，我你哋攞晒钱我都唔足，咁又买晒票咯，就系、是、咁简单。成个政治体系，我哋拣得呢个国家居住，就要接受呢个政治体系，就要接受呢样嘅决策，所以要去慢慢推进咧。我相信系仲一定嘅时间。
所以听讲有啲人就话批评民主社会面咧，政党更替咧，令到政策唔连贯，冇长远嘅策略咯。咁你譬如而家。我哋而家唔好講萬金先，講到聯邦政府而家話自由黨，因為驚保唔住嘅時候，一定要睇眼前，但睇眼前嘅嘢咪顧唔到長遠咯。所以呢個永遠係一個死胡同嚟，根本就係
大家都記得喺City of Toronto 一時有 LRT， 一時有 Subway 係嘛？咁結果今次 Premier 咧就話：你冇搞咁多啦，我將TTC 所有嘅 project 拎曬上去provincial。咁其實嗰個係一個幾好嘅方案，起碼我哋知道9年後會有一條transit Toronto transit 走出嚟，係咪？咁呢個 at least 有個時間表，就算佢拖慢咗嘅10年、11年，咁都有個底線咁樣。我覺得呢樣嘢係一個好好嘅改變咁樣。咁其實今日時間差唔多，咁大家有冇嘢補充？before 我哋即係完呢個節目，恭喜發財啦！如果冇特別嘢就係嘛？
我希望大家身體健康啦，係咪？自己做好自己個人衞生先，可以令到個社區都健康。
咁最緊要喺 COVID 期間咧，即係加好多 variant 啦，係咪？大家小心啲，盡量咧就係即係戴多啲口罩啊，勤洗手啊，咁啊 keep 個 physical distance 啊，唔需要去街嘅就唔需要去街啦。但係有時有啲個避免啊，過年啊，始終有啲喜慶嘢係咪？阿 Ben 有冇好多喜慶嘢啊？
冇，我哋絕對全部喺網上做曬佢噶啦。
好嘅，好，
免費反喺網上做埋噶啦。
好啦，咁大家恭喜發財啦，咁身體健康，好，拜拜，見到你，
咁拜拜。